Most Manda, Zora Sehgal, who lived up to 102, Sadashiv Amrapurkar, Ravi Chopra, Ashwant Singh, Manna De, V.K. Murthy, and apart from these, several more unsung heroes and technician artists.
We would like to commence the evening with a short audiovisual clip that encapsulates the journey of Whistling Woods International over the recent past. Let's have a look. I would now request our president, Ms. Meghna Ghaipuri, to please speak a few words. Whistling Woods is very close to her heart. She's someone who's been working longer than anyone has and is definitely the fulcrum of this institute's culture. We all agree to it. Meghna Ghaipuri, everyone.
Good evening. It's great to see this whole atmosphere of excitement of students passing out, and also to see that finally they are entering into the film industry, a different sector of life, different phase of life. So I feel very happy for them, and I also feel concerned for them, the graduates today, that they are a huge journey ahead. I remember my own journey when I passed out from FTI. I had a lot of dreams, a lot of aspirations, a lot of enthusiasm, a lot of stories in my mind that I will do this, I will do that, I will do this, I will break the industry, I will break stones, and I will so and so. But when I went to the industry, the first thing happened that I went to, with my diploma, to Gurudutt Studio, and the gatekeeper asked me, "Yes, what can I help you?" I says, "I'm a diploma holder from FTI." He could not understand. He said, "Ki probably main kuch kaise aaya hoon." So I said, I want to see shooting here inside Gurudutt Studio. And he said, "Do you know somebody?" I says, "No, I don't know anybody, but I'm a diploma holder of film school." He just closed the door. He closed the gate completely, and I was standing there for 5 minutes, and diploma was in my hand. And I was concerned. All my aspirations, all my dreams, all my thoughts, I've been carrying from my childhood, and my commitment to my parents and to my friends that I would be something. This door is closed for me. I do not know anyone. And from my story begins. I come home and start thinking. I picked up a book from a shelf, a Dale Carnegie book, How to Influence People. And I started reading that book. And that was my first book, learning book. And I shed all my previous books, Godard, Fellini, Kurosawa, Actor Prepares, every book and every film. And I said, I had to unlearn everything and start a new chapter. And I remember that I went office to office. That time the industry was different. It was a very isolated industry, film industry. There was only cinema, there was no television, there was no event, there was no digital, nothing. And competition was tough. But I started with one thing, that now I have to be a likable boy wherever I go. So I started my struggle meeting everyone with a smile. And trust me or not, I practically won everyone's heart first. Dimag hum baad mein jeete hain, pehle dusre ka dil jeete hain. Ye maine sikha. So I want to share with you, when I see you now, from tomorrow onward, you will be there. So sabse pehle, mere dosto, aapko ye seekhna hoga, ki jisse bhi main baat kar raha hoon, uska dil kaise jeetu. Chahe wo PN hai, ya emperor hai, ya boss hai, ya immediate boss hai. Dil se kaam karoge, dil se baat karoge, तो सुनने वाले को आपकी पूरी बात का समझ आएगी। अगर नॉलेज और इंटेलेक्चुअल्स और इंफॉर्मेशन और हाई लेवल पे बात करोगे तो वो भी हाई लेवल नॉलेज और टेक्निकली बात करेगा, और फिर दो नॉलेज और टेक्निकल जब टकराते हैं उसका फैसला कुछ नहीं हो पाता है। फैसला सिर्फ होता है कि दूसरे का दिल जीतना। सो आई रिमेम्बर कि एंड व्हेन आई met so many struggles when I became a producer, then I became an actor, then I became a writer, director, producer, and there was a constant blockbusters in my folder. So that time, so many students, so many newcomers used to come to my office. The history repeat. So I used to imagine myself in them. कि मैं भी तो ऐसे ही ऑफिस जाता था, और वो एक ही बात पूछते थे कि सब हम कहाँ जाएं, हमारे में टैलेंट है, हम कुछ करना चाहते हैं। एंड दैट वॉज अ टाइम आई वॉज मेकिंग सौदागर एंड आई शेयर दिस फीलिंग विद मिस्टर दिलीप कुमार एंड मिस्टर सुनील दत्त, टू पीपल। आई सेड कि आई हैव एन आइडिया दैट आई वॉन्ट टू सेट अप ए प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर ऑल दोज चिल्ड्रन फ्रॉम वेरियस स्टेट एंड हु कैन कम हियर एंड हैव ए लाइब्रेरी या ए कॉफी शॉप काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग वेयर दे कैन सिट डाउन and they can meet the industry people. But how to connect the industry people and industry producers or the mass media people? So let's have some kind of institution, a school, where we can train them, and also they will spend some time. To bole kya padhenge, mujhe unhone kaha, ye to yaar har ek mein talent hota hai, wahi aata hai। मेहमल साहब, बहुत से लोगों में टैलेंट होता है लेकिन उनको पता नहीं होता है। दे डू नॉट नो कि दे हैव, लाइक आई नेवर न्यू कि आई कुड बी राइटर, आई नेवर न्यू आई कुड बी डायरेक्टर। सो दे विल डिस्कवर एंड रीडिस्कवर व्हेन दे हैव दिस प्लेटफॉर्म। एंड दैट वाज द थिंग व्हेन आई अप्लाई टू द गवर्नमेंट 1992 दैट आई वॉन्ट अ लिटल पीस ऑफ लैंड वेर आई कैन सेट अप वेर आई कैन स्पेंड ऑल माई मनी, माई एक्सपीरियंस, माई नॉलेज। एंड आई वेंट टू ईच एवरी एक्सपर्ट and then I picked up my bag and camera and I went to various countries, to various film school, to meet those dean and those faculty people, that where did you go wrong. I never asked them how did you achieve, I asked them where did you go wrong, and they smiled and they started sharing with me, and I made a note, I came back and I came to know that we can do that for our Indian children also. And rest is a struggle, and rest is a, I would say, ek ladai thi, ek fight thi. But I was lucky enough that I could win the heart of many filmmakers, many technicians who came along with me that time. Okay, let's open the school. And a lot of faculty members who are still here with me, and a lot of people like Anand Mahindra, like Shyam Benekal, Shabana Azmi, everyone joined us, and we started setting up this institute. And exactly 10 years back, I could see that it is happening when I saw 80 students like you who are there to inaugurate our Whistling Booth on 18th July 2006. So now it was a second now struggle for me. I have done it, done my bit, lekin where, how could we succeed in film school? There is no film school. The way I think the film school should be, the way I visioned, because I had learned a lot of things from the various film schools, what to do and what not to do, what to teach and what not to teach. One thing which I came to know was common: let the students grow themselves. Let the students be the teacher for themselves. We are not teachers, we are mentors. Let the student educate themselves, give them the environments, give them the facilities, give them the technology, and see to it that they groom themselves. And I'm very happy that today is 10th year, and 10th year may I have been meeting all students personally sometime in group, and I could see the smile in their face, the confidence growing every 6 months, every 3 months, and when they are here, I can tell you that these are the people, you never know who will open the new institute for themselves also one day when you will get successful. You will be the leader because you are from tomorrow's leader, as every politician say. But you should be leader for yourself. The purpose of this institute, we trained only on three factors. The students must develop his artistic skill and the knowledge of technology. And third, which is most important, the human in him. The human touch in him is most important, apart from the technological skill or the artistic skill. And I can tell you proudly that whenever our students or alumni are working, all the bosses have been telling me the same thing. Your boys are brilliant, and more than brilliant, they are good people, they are good persons. And I always feel nice, and I trust me or not, that time I feel my dream has come true now. Having said that, I really bless you and wish you all the best. And your success is my success, our success, the success of Wrestling Boots. Whenever you need us, we are always there. It is just that you should understand, you have just passed one phase of your life. You should remain all the time the student and student and student. Till I am still a student. I also have learned from you. I also learned from youngsters. So never leave a studentship in you and a humility and humbleness in you. And once you do that, nobody can stop you to reach to zenith. And having said that, now I must thank our great friend Ajay Bijli. He's an example who had just one theater. Ajay Bijli is my very good old friend. When he saw my struggles right from the beginning as an actor, and I also saw him taking passionately about his theater. He was the person in Delhi in theater, I remember, when he would, that time nobody used to bother about the technology or the sound part of it, screen theek hai ki nahi, sound hai ki nahi. Sabko ye tha ki paise hai ki nahi, aur kaise karke theater chalti hai. They used to discuss more of the stories or movies. But whenever I used to meet and visit his theater, he would show me how much update he has done in the technology. He was very great student of sound and picture. He was always passionately updating his cinema all the time. And I could see, here's a man. Every specialization, whatever you do, you have to do passionately. And that is why today you can see Ajay Bijli is today the leading man in exhibition in the film industry. And we have a 5,000 screening, and you can see the totally game, the name of the game has changed. And I would say full credit goes to Mr. Ajay Bijli as a leader. Thank you for coming, sir. And also, I keep thanking every year, every month, every weekend to my friend. His name is Manmohan Shetty. So I think I always feel like to thank him in public also in my speech, because normally main thank unko karta hi nahi hu. To ek jagah mic milti hai jahan mujhe lagta hai ki mujhe thank you kehna chahiye, because he has been a source of inspiration right from the construction of the Whistling Boots. He was the first the board member of Whistling Boots who encouraged me, and he told me one thing I still remember. He told me, Subhash, कोई भी बिजनेस करना, वो बिजनेस करना जो किसी ने ना किया हो, वो काम करना जो किसी ने ना किया हो. एंड ही हिमसेल्फ इज एग्जांपल. ही स्टार्टेड विद आईमैक्स. देयर वाज नो आईमैक्स थिएटर इन दिस कंट्री, एंड ही मेड हिज प्रेजेंस फेल्ट. एंड देन ही वाज द पर्सन हु डेवलप्ड मल्टीप्लेक्सेस इन दिस कंट्री. एम आई राइट सर? ही वाज द फर्स्ट. अजय जी. And now he is a king of Imagica, you understand, the first kind of a theme park, the biggest theme park, as good as an international standard, Imagica, and everybody's talking about. And Raviji, we all know he's a part of Whistling Boots, part of Mukta Arts, part of our growth. Thank you, sir. Thank you for being here. And thank you all for being here. And my best wishes to all of you. Love you.
Thank you so much, sir. Firstly, before we move forward, can I...
Additional exercise. Since Wesley Wood has been indebted to the film industry, because the whole film industry, entire media industry, come to our Whistling Woods to teach our students, to interact with them. Since return, we feel we are indebted, and we must create a 2 Maestro Award every year. And the creation of Maestro Award is our tribute to their contribution as a legend, artists or technicians. So we have 2 awards, one for the technician and one for the artist. Artist means the actors. And this is the 10th year, and we are really honored that legend like Lataji accepted to receive our award, and Mr. Vinod Khanna. When I called Lataji that I would like to invite you, so she called me at home. She said, ki, Subhash, main samajh sakti hu ki aap logo ne kitna kaam kiya hai aur dur se main dekh sakti hu. लेकिन मेरी उम्र काफ़ी ढल चुकी है. आज मैं 86 की हो गई हूँ. घर से भी बाहर नहीं निकलती हूँ और मेरा मन बहुत करता है कि मैं जाऊँ बिस्ली वुड्स, देखूँ उन वहाँ के बच्चों को मिलूँ, वहाँ के म्यूज़िक स्कूल के बच्चों को मिलूँ, सबको मिलूँ. लेकिन दुर्भाग्य से मेरा होना नहीं पा रहा है. तो फिर लेकिन मैं चाहती हूँ कि स्टूडेंट से मैं ज़रूर आऊँगी. मैं ये वादा करती हूँ कि जैसे मैं ठीक हो जाऊँगी. तो इसीलिए उन्होंने एक अपना मैसेज हमारे लिए भेजा है और फिर हमने उनके घर में ही उन्हें वो अवार्ड दिया और आपके सामने एक छोटा ये भी प्रेजेंट करेंगे. लता मंगेशकर जी.
स्टूडेंट सीख के जा रहे हैं, मैं उनको बहुत बहुत शुभकामनाएं देती हूँ. मैं बहुत आना चाहती थी पर किसी वजह से मैं आ नहीं सकी, पर मैं आपको वादा करती हूँ कि मैं ज़रूर आऊँगी. आप सब ने मुझे जो पुरस्कार दिया है उसके लिए मैं बहुत आभारी हूँ और मैं आप सबको भविष्य में बहुत बहुत यश मिले ऐसे ईश्वर से प्रार्थना करती हूँ. नमस्कार.
आफ्टर लता जी, हु डज नॉट से दिस कि लता जी जैसा कोई नहीं, हम भी नहीं, इनसे सीखने की. तो इसीलिए हमने आज एक बहुत ही यंग टैलेंट सिंगर को इनवाइट किया है कि वो आए और लता जी के ट्रिब्यूट में थोड़ा सा 2 पंक्तियां या 4 पंक्तियां जरूर गाएं. और नई सिंगर हैं, हमारी उभरती सिंगर हैं, उनका नाम है ऐश्वर्या राय. नहीं, ऐश्वर्या, आइए ऐश्वर्या जी पर आइए. गिव अ बिग हैंड टू. ऐश्वर्या जी की इंट्रोडक्शन आप पढ़ेंगे, मैं पढ़ूं.
ऐश्वर्या मजुमदार won the musical reality show Amul Star Voice of India at the age of 15. She obtained the Chote Ustad Award from Mr. Amitabh Bachchan. She has sung many Gujarati songs and recently recorded.
We all fondly call him SG. Called me up yesterday and asked me to be a part of today. I was more than thrilled, more than honored. I cannot imagine. To be a part of something that is so huge, and especially when it comes to being in honor of such a legendary person, I think I run out of words to be thankful. So anyway, I'm going to give a big thank you to the entire team of Whistling Woods and of course SG. Lataji is someone who has inspired each one of us in one or the other way in life. And my mouth goes dry when I have to sing something as I dedicate this to her. What more appropriate than this song?
Naam gum jayega चेहरा ये बदल जाएगा, मेरी आवाज़ ही पहचान चेहरा ये बदल जाएगा, मेरी आवाज ही पहचान है, गर याद रहे.
थैंक यू वंस अगेन.
ग्रेट. थैंक यू. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सो मच. थैंक यू.
God bless you. Lovely, lovely, fantastic. Thank you, Aishwarya. Now back to our convocations. I would like to invite our honorable guest for the keynotes, Mr. Ajay Bijli Sahab. Please. I think I've spoken enough for him. Now you know him also. Please come. Big hand. Thank you, sir. Thank you for coming. I'm Anand Khanna here, that in spite of his not good health, he has made all the way from the town and coming here just to bless all of you, just to bless all of you. And thank you, his wife Kavita, for coming here and bringing him here with all love and affection for the Institute, because Vinod ji is not only a big star of our country or a politician of this country, but also he has always supported Whistling Woods right from the beginning, and he has been a trustee for Whistling Woods for many years. Give a big hand, please, for them. Today we really feel honored to honor him with the Maestro Award for his great contribution in cinema. I think we should display AV, which will speak better than me. So it is okay that we start AV for Mr. Vinod Khanna, because we are going to honor him with the Maestro Award. CC says okay for me. AV, play.
A huge round of applause for Mr. Vinod Khanna, please. I would like to request Meghna ma'am to please present the award to Mr. Vinod Khanna. Mr. Khanna, I kindly request you to say a few words.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Subhashji, Shetty ji, everybody on the dais. Distinguished guests, members of the faculty, all the students present. First of all, of course, I'm really grateful, humbled by Whistling Woods, by Mr. Ghai and his team for having chosen me for this award this year. I'm not a great one for giving speeches, and neither do I ever prepare my speeches. I'll speak what comes to my heart. I know all you people in Whistling Woods must be having a very trying time graduating. Fortunately, मैं जब फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में आया, उन दिनों में कोई फिल्म एक्टिंग स्कूल्स नहीं थे. एक स्कूल शुरू हुआ था, द फिल्म इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ पुणे, लेकिन मैं उससे पहले फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में आ चुका था. आई हैड नो बैकग्राउंड ऑफ एक्टिंग. द ओनली एक्सपीरियंस दैट आई एवर हैड यू नो ऑफ गोइंग ऑन स्टेज वॉज इन स्कूल एंड कॉलेज एंड दैट ऑल्सो आई हैड टू गैदर अ लॉट ऑफ करेज एंड गेट रिड ऑफ माई फियर द स्टेज फ्राइट लाइक वी ऑल नो. But the day I did my first play in school, and my teacher who directed me, he was one person who inculcated in me the love for acting. I never ever knew what acting was, because you know, as children you don't know what acting is compared to what your normal behavior is. But coming on the stage and acting a part of a character which you had no idea about, no experience about, and all you could do to give your best was what you were told by your director and by what the play demanded from you. So that was my first experience with acting. And that seed was sown inside me. So after I finished my school, went to college, I did a little bit of stage in college also. And then suddenly out of the blues, pata nahi isko aap bhagya kehte hain, destiny kehte hain, jo bhi kehte hain, mujhe ek din Sunil Dutt ji, hamare I would call him my godfather kind of a person, met me somewhere as a college student. I was 19 years old. And he looked at me so intensely, and after 2 days I get a message from his office saying that, you know, that he's in the making, he's in the planning of a film in which he needs some newcomers. And if I would be interested. For me, that was a big challenge because my background was I come from a business family. My family was getting me ready to join the business. And telling them that, you know, I don't want to join your business and join the film industry was the most difficult thing that ever came out of my mouth. I just went to my father. And I told him that this is the offer I've got, and I'm really, really keen to do this. Please allow me to do this. I don't want to do this without your permission. My father rejected it immediately. He was so angry that he pulled out a gun, a revolver, and he put it on my head. And he said, "Don't you ever say those words again. Film industry is out. You can do anything else you want. But you cannot join the film industry." Because in those days, the film industry did not have a reputation, you know, where families wanted their children to go and join. Anyway, I convinced my parents. I told them, "Please give me 2 years. If I'm not successful in 2 years, I promise you, I will quit the film industry and I will come and join your business." And that was the end of it. They agreed. And then, of course, my whole journey into the film industry began. As an actor, nobody comes born as an actor. Nobody knows, no matter how great a family you come from of acting or film industry, anybody in the film industry. It has to be within you. It has to be something which you really want to do, which you really want to give everything that you've got. Like in any other profession, but this profession especially. And I went on working, and fortunately there were a number of films that came my way after my first release. I was accepted, I was recognized, and I got so many films, one after the other. I played all kinds of roles. I was somebody who knew nothing about the film industry because I had no experience of the film industry. Nobody in my family was in the film industry. And I learned step by step. Every person I met, whether he was a spot boy, whether he was an assistant director, whether he was my producer, my director, anybody who was working in any department, I was always willing to listen and learn from them. And by the grace of God, I must say that one thing paid off in my life. You have to be open, listen to people, observe people, take their advice where, as and when you feel it's correct. But listening is the most important thing in acting, I feel. Anyway, I went through this whole journey for many years. And I came to a point of life where I had achieved everything. I had everything that I wanted, recognition. I had won awards. I had made a lot of money. I traveled the world. Everything that somebody can hope for, I had got. But yet, something within me kept saying that, no, there is more, there is more. There's something that you need to do, which you're not doing. And I could never pinpoint it. And then suddenly, I met my guru. Like, he's known as Osho today. In those days, he was known as Rajneesh, Bhagwan Rajneesh. And I went into this path of meditation and spirituality, which was there somewhere inside me for a very, very long time, but it had been, you know, usko daba diya tha maine. I didn't like it to surface because my career, everything else was so important. Anyway, this whole journey started, and I used to have a lot of discontent in my work, you know, with my producers, with my directors, with my story writers, with my co-actors. You know, there used to be a lot of conflict. There used to be a lot of, times where I would go home very dissatisfied with my work. And I could never find out why that is there, because I would really give everything I got into my work. So I spoke to my guru one day, and I'd like to share this with you. I told him, this is what is happening with me, that I cannot work with people that I don't agree with. People that whose mind and my mind don't think alike. What should I do? Because I come home very dissatisfied. I go home, I can't sleep till very late. So main kya karu? I think this is something which all of you will face probably tomorrow. So he gave me a very simple, simple answer which I couldn't understand straight away. उन्होंने मुझे कहा कि देखो विनोद, हर आदमी का एक सेल होता है, हाँ, स्पेस होती है जिसमें उसको फंक्शन करना पड़ता है. तो हर किसी का सेल 5x5 है या 7x7 है या 10x10 है. Or you're confined in that space. But to feel free of that space, unless you're total 100% in that space with awareness, you will never be able to be satisfied. तो उन्होंने मुझे कहा कि तुम जहां भी हो, तुम्हें जो भी काम मिलता है, जो भी तुम्हारा डायरेक्टर बोलता है, जो भी तुम्हारा प्रोड्यूसर बोलता है, जितना वाहियात सीन हो, जितना बकवास सीन हो, तुमसे बिल्कुल, तुमको बिल्कुल भाता नहीं है, लेकिन तुम वो करो जो वो कह रहे हैं. 100% अपने आप को उसमें डुबो दो. और मुझे लगा कि मैं, यू नो, बिकॉज द माइंड इज सच अ थिंग दैट देयर सो मच कॉन्फ्लिक्ट, करूं नहीं करूं, ये यू नो क्वेश्चंस कीप कमिंग, यू कीप फाइटिंग. एनीवे आई सेड लेट मी ट्राई दिस आउट, एंड आई स्टार्टेड डूइंग दिस. आई यूज्ड टू कम ऑन द सेट. And even if I didn't agree with the scene, I didn't agree with so many things that were happening, whether it was production, it was, I just said, main bilkul complain nahi karunga, jo mujhe kehte hain main 100% usme doob jaunga. And I swear I tell you that changed my entire outlook towards my work. Once I started doing that, but with awareness, वो सारा गुस्सा मेरे अंदर जो था वो सारा गायब होना शुरू हो गया. I started loving people, I started accepting him. क्योंकि उन्होंने कहा तुम्हारा जो सेल है उनका भी वही सेल है. अगर तुम्हारा 7x7 का सेल प्रिजन का सेल है तो उनका भी प्रिजन का सेल है. अगर तुम उनके साथ झगड़ा करोगे वो भी घर जाएंगे, वो अपनी बीवी से झगड़ा करेगा, बीवी अपने बच्चों से झगड़ा करेगी. एंड दिस साइकिल कंटिन्यूज एंड नोबडी देन इज हैप्पी. सो टू बी हैप्पी टू बी सैटिस्फाइड ऑल यू गॉट टू डू इज बी 100% in whatever you are doing, no matter how stupid, no matter how much you disagree with it, but do it, but with awareness. Ye maine karna shuru kiya and I tell you my whole life changed. And I started enjoying my work, my people, my friends, my colleagues in the industry so much. Everything became so heavenly, I must say, that everything changed. And then I suddenly realized that my God, इतनी सिंपल सी चीज थी और उसको समझने के लिए मुझे इतना समय लगा. I don't know it's so easy for you to understand it today also unless you start doing it. But when this happened to me, my whole life changed. I was content, happy. I was meditating, you know, 6 hours a day whenever I could find time. In between shots, I would close my makeup room and sit down to meditate. And suddenly, I was a very happy man. And then I went to the guru again, once in Pune, and he asked me, kya ho raha? Toh I said, Bhagwan, aapne toh kamal ka mujhe formula de diya, mujhe toh bahut maza aa raha aajkal. Itna achha lag raha mujhe. Kaam kar raha hoon, mujhe har cheez mein anand aata hai. So he smiled at me and he said, theek hai. अब आगे देखते हैं क्या होता है. एंड द नेक्स्ट थिंग आई न्यू इज दैट आफ्टर हैविंग यू नो सो नाइसली सेटल्ड विथ माय वर्क दैट आई जस्ट फेल्ट दैट आई कांट मिस दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ नॉट बीइंग विथ माय गुरु फिजिकली. सो आई जस्ट डिसाइडेड दैट आई मस्ट quit the film industry and be with him. And that's the time I decided, and I spent a few years, I quit the industry, spent a few years with him, went with him to America, came back, finished my journey, and then I told him when I came back that I want to go back and work in the film industry. I want to go back and be with my friends and family. And he was so happy. He said, yes, now you can go back. And I came back, started my work again, started everything. And that whole journey that I went through, I'm the most grateful person. I would always be indebted to my guru. And of course, gurus are in all your walks of life. You know, your director is your guru, your producer is your guru, your colleagues are your gurus, because you learn from everybody. And that's what I said, you must listen and learn. But there's an opportunity to learn from everywhere, from everybody. So, I know it's nothing much that I've shared with you. Unfortunately, you know, Subhashji and me never got to work in a film together as a director and actor, but I must tell you that we've shared more of a relationship than that. But I always looked forward to be directed by Subhashji. It never happened. And I saw his whole journey also. In fact, when I came, jab main film industry mein aaya tha, to main ek film kar raha tha aur film institute se bahut sare ladke graduate hoke aaye the. Unme se Subhashji bhi ek the. And I was working on a set one day and suddenly my director comes and says ki ye Subhashji Subhash Ghai hai aur ye role kar rahe hai kuch freedom fighter ka role tha aisa kuch tha. And You know, coming from the Film Institute, obviously you've been trained. And Subhashji came and he rattled off this huge passage of freedom fighter ki speech wagera thi. Main to ghabra gaya, main to dar gaya. Kyunki maine kabhi is tarah ka dialogue suna nahi tha. Lekin mujhe us waqt laga ki yaar training is so important. You know, coming from a background of training, because when you come, you've been taught to face the camera, you've been taught to, you know, how to deliver your lines, you've been taught all these kind of things. And I was so happy to meet him and to learn about the Film Institute, because mujhe nahi pata tha. Uske baad immediately I did a film called Mere Apne, in which the entire Film Institute ki gang was there. Main akela tha, right from Mr. Shatrughan Sinha, my dearest friend, to Danny, to a whole lot of them who graduated and came. Aur main akela ek taraf hota tha aur ye puri Film Institute ek taraf hoti thi. But we all got on famously. We did a great film. It did very well. So I'm really grateful to everybody who's come into my life and from whom I've learned, from whom I've had the opportunity to learn. And I hope that all of you graduates today will keep all this in mind. And the little that I've said will probably also help you in your journey. So thank you once again for this honor. Thank you once again for this. Because, you know, ultimately, it is these kind of recognitions that make you feel that, yes, your efforts have not gone in vain, that you have made a difference in the world. So thank you very much. I'm in politics, as you know. I've been elected 4 times Member of Parliament from the same constituency. Mujhe politics ke baare mein bhi kuch pata nahi tha. Mujhe jab aisa laga ki bhai maine sab kuch dekh liya hai, achieve kar liya hai, sab kuch kama liya hai, to abhi mujhe kuch wapas karna chahiye. Apne logon ko, apne fans ko, apne chahane walon ko. The only way I felt that you could do that was to work for the people. And no matter what reputation politics has, please let me tell you, I'm in politics. I used to hate politicians. I used to hate politics. But when I came into parliament and when I went into my constituency and I saw the halat of the poor people, the downtrodden, politics gives you the greatest opportunity, the biggest platform to work for the upliftment of the poor. And I'm so grateful to the Almighty, to my party, for giving me this opportunity of working for the people. And believe me, it is very satisfying when you see the lives of people changing and becoming better. So we should never leave any aspect of life out. That's what my point was. I mean, you know, we all say politics is dirty, politics is this, politics is that. We have all kinds of peoples in all walks of life. But it's up to you. What advantage you take of that situation, of the opportunity given to you, and make the best of it. So I have led a very fruitful, very satisfying life. And I'm grateful to the Almighty, of course, and all my family, colleagues. My family has been the biggest supporter of mine. My wife Kavita is here, my children are here, Sakshi, Shraddha. I've already got 2 sons in the film industry. I think I was the first person who said yes when Akshay told me that he wants to become an actor. I never came in his way. Rahul wanted to be an actor. I never came in his way. There is no business like show business. That's a fact, because I've seen the entire world. I've seen all kinds of professions. I've seen people successful in all kinds of professions. But the satisfaction, the joy Satisfaction, I mean your soul. I think this is the only industry, this is the only kind of profession that gives you the opportunity to find that peace and love in work. So thank you. Enjoy yourself. Enjoy your life. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Vinod.
A commendation for excellence in cinematography goes to Arkadev Mukherjee. Ravi is not here, so... For the Whistling Woods School of Filmmaking, commendation for excellence in screenwriting, that goes to Suchita Ranglani. Alright, the last award is... Photos. Photo call, please.
So, yet bearing in mind what we've learned. My fellow graduates, today we've gathered here for one last hurrah before some of us move on to studying further and some of us to paying taxes. With our curious little minds fiercely entering into a new world, almost dreamy-eyed, not knowing how many deadlines we'd be facing, forget knowing how many we'd actually even meet.
Hi, everybody. Oh. First of all, I must tell you what is Maestro Award given by Whistling Woods. Whistling Woods is celebrating 10th year this year. So Whistling Woods could not exist and could not achieve its achievements until and unless there was a support from the industry. For the last 10 years, so many legends, so many directors, stars, writers, they've been contributing by teaching students for the last 10 years. So Whistling Woods always felt indebted, and they instituted an award by the students and faculty. It's called a Maestro Award. The two awards every year. So this year, awards were given to Lataji and Vinodji as an actor, and that is why we are here. So you should know what is Maestro Award given by Whistling Woods. Now over to our Maestro Award winner today. It is an honor to us, honor to Institute. Vinodji has always stood by us, and he has been contributing a lot in building up this Whistling Woods. And now over to...
Haji, question answers you.
मैं हिंदी में बोला मैं ये कहना चाहूंगा कि जब तक हिंदुस्तान के
बॉम्बे फिल्म इंडस्ट्री के हिंदी सिनेमा के सितारों का, निर्देशक का, राइटर्स का, एकेडमिक्स का साथ ना होता तो विस्लिंग वुड्स ना होता। विस्लिंग वुड्स आज 10वें साल में है और इतनी तरक्की पे है कि वर्ल्ड का टॉप 10 बन गया है। इसका जो पूरा श्रेय है वो हमारी इंडस्ट्री को जाता है और विनोद जी और दिलीप कुमार और सब लोगों के जैसे लीजेंड्स हैं उनको जाता है। तो ये सक्सेस मेरी नहीं है, ये हमारे इंडस्ट्री की सक्सेस है, हमारे सभी आर्टिस्ट और टेक्नीशियंस की सक्सेस है जिन्होंने अपना ज्ञान और अपनी नॉलेज जो है स्टूडेंट्स को दी। आने वाली जो जनरेशन है फिल्म मेकर्स हैं उनको बांटा और उनसे भी कनेक्ट किया। तो हमारे जितने स्टूडेंट्स हैं वो इंडस्ट्री में जाकर जब उनको मिलते हैं तो एक जान पहचान ऑलरेडी होती है, एक विचार भी आपस में मिलते हैं। ये एक बहुत बड़ी अचीवमेंट हमने पाई। जो फिल्म फैमिलीज होती हैं उनकी एक प्रिविलेज तो होता है कि जैसे पॉलिटिशियन का बेटा पॉलिटिशियन, डॉक्टर का बेटा डॉक्टर, आर्मी का बेटा आर्मी, तो हमारी एक प्रथा भी है और उसमें गुण भी होता है क्योंकि फिल्म फैमिली में जो बच्चा बड़ा होता है उसको बचपन से ही 6 साल की उम्र से ट्रेनिंग मिलती है। वो अपने माता पिता को देखता है, थोड़े जेनेटिक भी लेकर आते हैं, थोड़े जीन्स में आते हैं और फिर वो ट्रेनिंग भी उसके अपने घर में होती है। लेकिन सबसे खूबसूरत बात जो फिल्म इंडस्ट्री की है, जब विनोद खन्ना साहब आए तो इनके पिताजी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री में नहीं थे, ये बाहर से आए थे। तो जब बाहर से भी बहुत से जब लोग होते हैं, सबसे अच्छी खूबसूरत बात यह है फिल्म इंडस्ट्री की, ये मेरिटोरियस इंडस्ट्री है। यहाँ मेरिट होगी तो आप जीतेंगे, चाहे वो फिल्म के बच्चे हैं, फिल्म वालों के बच्चे हैं या बाहर के बच्चे हैं। तो कंपटीशन जो है बहुत ओपन है, तो उस ओपन कंपटीशन में कभी बच्चे जीतते हैं, कभी बाहर के लोग जीतते हैं। या शाहरुख जो है वो बाहर से हैं, आमिर खान एक फिल्म फैमिली से हैं, सलमान फिल्म फैमिली से हैं, लेकिन अक्षय कुमार जो हैं वो बाहर से हैं। तो बहुत से ऐसे एक्टर्स आपको मिलेंगे, डायरेक्टर्स मिलेंगे। मैं बाहर से हूँ, मैं भी किसी राज कपूर या यशोड़ का बेटा नहीं था। तो मेरिट्स के ऊपर जीतना जो है ये हमारी इंडस्ट्री की सबसे बड़ी क्वालिटी है। आज आप सोचिए कि कितना बड़ा मोमेंट होगा हमारा कि जो हमने अपनी फिल्म इंडस्ट्री के लिए किया या फिल्म इंडस्ट्री से जो पाया वो हमने फिल्म इंडस्ट्री को दिया। 35 साल के कैरियर के बाद, इतनी फिल्में बनाने के बाद, 20 फिल्में मैंने डायरेक्ट की और 20 हमने प्रोड्यूस की। उसके बाद जितने भी हमारा नॉलेज एक्सपीरियंस जो भी धन यश था वो फिल्म इंस्टीट्यूट में बांटा, विस्ली वुड्स में दिया और उसको विस्ली वुड्स को खड़ा करने में और उसको आगे बढ़ाने में मेघना गाईपुरी का, राहुलपुरी का बहुत बड़ा हाथ है। क्योंकि इसको नेक्स्ट जनरेशन ही संभाल सकती है, हम तो सिर्फ ज्ञान दे सकते हैं, काम तो उन्होंने ही करना है, एग्जीक्यूट उन्होंने करना है, आगे भी उन्होंने बढ़ाना है। तो आज मुझे बहुत खुशी है कि आज 10वां साल है हमारा, 10th ईयर में एंटर कर रहे हैं और हमारे बच्चे जितने भी बाहर गए हैं अच्छी अच्छी कंपनियों में एक बड़े बड़े अहदे पर हैं। बाकी रही बात एक्टर्स की और स्टार्स की, स्टार्स को भी एक कंपटीशन होता है, उसको हर एक को टाइम लगता है, किसी को 6 साल, किसी को 7 साल, तो वो लगेगा और आपके सामने वो आएंगे। राजेश खन्ना हमारे मित्र थे, विनोद जी के भी मित्र थे, आज हम उनको मिस करते हैं। राजेश खन्ना ने जो करिश्मा अपना करियर किया था 25 साल तक, एक उनकी जो इनिंग उन्होंने प्ले की एक बहुत खूबसूरत इनिंग थी, उनका जो सुपर स्टारडम जो पहला एक फ्रेंजी जो पैदा हुई थी वो फ्रेंजी राजेश खन्ना ने क्रिएट की थी और आज हम वो डेफिनेटली मिस करते हैं, इंडस्ट्री को याद करती है, हम उनका सम्मान करते थे और करते हैं।
सर एज अ डायरेक्टर मैं आपसे पूछना चाहूँगी, जो स्टॉकिंग चीज होती है, जो बहुत सारे फिल्म स्टार वो अक्नॉलेज करते हैं कि यार स्टॉकिंग लुक्स गुड ऑन स्क्रीन, तो उसकी जो रियल लाइफ में बहुत कंसीक्वेंसेस जो हम देख रहे हैं, तो व्हाट्स योर टेक ऑन
ये टॉपिक? जरा सोशल इशू है, पहले हम लोग विस्लूट्स की बात कर लें, विनोद जी ने बात करनी है, ये जो टॉपिक है चलेगा, ये भाग दो में आएगा है ना, फिर भाग तीन में गॉसिप आएगा है ना, अभी जरा इसकी बात करते हैं, तीन भाग में बांट लेते हैं। आप मुझे मालूम है लास्ट क्वेश्चन की वेट कर रहे हैं।
परेशान कर रहा है ज्यादा से ज्यादा थोड़ी देर, अप्रोक्सीमेटली 1 आवर परेशान कर रहा है, बाद में मान जाती है, तो आपको कहीं ना कहीं ऐसा नहीं लगता की टीनेजर के दिमाग में ऐसा एक बैठ जाता है कि हाँ जो हीरो जो कर रहा है वो सही कर रहा है और वो वही करता है, और आप जो लोग पहले करते थे आपके टाइम पे ओवर कल्चरल और ट्रेडिशनल वाला था इंडस्ट्री, तो आपको क्या कहना है इस बारे में?
आई डोंट थिंक इस पर कोई कॉमेंट देने की ज़रूरत है. इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन जनरेशन टू जनरेशन एज द जनरेशन इन्वॉल्व. पहले सीटी बजाना बस ओके, आज सीटी बजाओ तो जेल में जाओगे. आई मीन सी वी वर ब्रॉट अप इन अ टाइम वेयर दीज वेर एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ ग्रोइंग अप, टीजिंग गर्ल्स, सीटी बजाना, यू नो द होल थिंग ऑफ the krishna
theory.
Now everything is different, so every generation goes through a certain change and it's for the good. I think everything is evolution basically.
Aur aapko ye samajhna chahiye
baki good and bad is the same in everybody. Sabko pata hai kya theek hai, sabko pata hai kya galat hai, correct? Aisi koi baat, I don't think there's anybody who doesn't know that.
Aur cinema jo hai wo hamesha apne जो उस काल का, उस वर्तमान काल का दर्पण होता है,
रिफ्लेक्शन.
उस तरह से जो 1940 के जो यंगस्टर थे वो अलग थे, वो देशभक्ति वाले थे, फिर 60 वाले वो शादी वाले थे, 80 वाले रोमांटिक वाले थे, अभी अग्रेसिव वाले हैं, अभी तो दो तीन गर्लफ्रेंड भी रख के स्टोरी बनाते हैं लाइफ में भी ऐसे. तो जितने भी फ्रेंड्स हैं जो जनरेशन है उसका वही जनरेशन स्क्रीन पर आती है, तो देखने वाले भी जवान, बनाने वाले भी जवान और कहानी भी जवान, अपने समय के अनुरूप. इसलिए समय का बदला कर सिनेमा तो नहीं बदलेगा, सिनेमा वैसे ही बदलेगा, लेकिन आज का जो पिता है, जैसे आज का पिता रो रहा है, आप फिल्मों में ही देख रहे हैं पिता उतना ही रो रहा है जितना रोना चाहिए. आगे क्या
मैं एक बात कहना चाहूँगी कि एटलीस्ट विस्लिंग वुड्स में जो हमारी ट्रेनिंग में हम ट्राई करते हैं कि हम हमारे स्टूडेंट्स को सेंसिटाइज करते हैं इन बातों पर, चाहे वो जेंडर सेंसिटाइजेशन की वर्कशॉप्स हों, चाहे वो कैसे आप एक मुद्दे को लेके, एक सोशल इशू को लेके आप सेंसिटिवली उसको कैसे बता सकते हैं. तो ये जो है उनकी ट्रेनिंग का एक 3 साल में उनको हर टाइम वो ट्रेनिंग मिलती रहती है. तो मेरा होप है कि ये बच्चे भी आके सोसाइटी की ही पिक्चर बताएंगे, उनकी मतलब फिल्मों की स्टोरीज वही होंगी, बट यस वो सोशली रिस्पॉन्सिबली वे में भी दिखाई जाएंगी. तो आई एम होपफुल फॉर द फ्यूचर.
क्योंकि मेघना जो है बहुत वर्कशॉप देती हैं, चाहे वो वुमेन रिस्पेक्ट की हों, ह्यूमन रिस्पेक्ट की हों, डिप्राइव्ड लोगों की हों, पुअर की हों,
उनके बारे में अगर वो विलेज में जाके काम नहीं करेंगे तो ये स्टूडेंट्स को बहुत एक्सपोजर मिलता है रियलिटी का. और यही बेनिफिट है फिल्म स्कूल में आने का, आप कहीं भी कुछ भी बन सकते हैं, बट अगर आपकी ट्रेनिंग अच्छी हो तो आपको अच्छे वैल्यूज मिलते हैं.
सॉरी
सर, कितना एक्सपीरियंस होता है स्टूडेंट से मिलते हैं, बात करते हैं, इस तरीके के इवेंट्स आते हैं, उसके बारे में सर कुछ बताना चाहेंगे?
स्टूडेंट्स को मिलके आपको क्या लगता है?
नहीं, स्टूडेंट्स को तो अभी मैं दो दो मिनट के लिए मिला, आई एम नॉट बीन एबल टू एक्सचेंज विद देम.
बट जब आप स्टूडेंट थे,
हाँ नेचुरली, आई मीन ऑल दीज सेरेमनीज जो होती हैं, कॉन्वोकेशन हो, ग्रेजुएशन हो, ये है, ये सब आपको याद दिलाती हैं अपने टाइम की. बट एवरी वी ऑल वेंट थ्रू डिफरेंट सिस्टम्स, डिफरेंट टाइम्स, डिफरेंट टीचर्स, डिफरेंट थिंकिंग, डिफरेंट कंडीशनिंग. सो बट व्हाट आई सी द फेसेस ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स जो मैंने देखा आज, दे आर ऑल्सो एक्साइटेड, दे ऑल्सो यू नो बीमिंग विद जॉय, कॉन्फिडेंस लेवल्स उनका हमारे वक्त से बहुत ज़्यादा है. यू नो इवन जब लोग फिल्म इंस्टीट्यूट पूना से ग्रेजुएट होके आते थे, चाहे वो टेक्नीशियंस हों, एक्टर्स हों, दी स्टूडेंट्स आर मच मोर कॉन्फिडेंट देन दोज स्टूडेंट्स ऑल्सो, बिकॉज इंटरनेट इज ओपनड अप, इंफॉर्मेशन इज ओपनड अप, सो मच थिंग इज ओपनड अप, यू नो देयर सो मच अवेलेबल. आई मीन दे डोंट जस्ट हैव टू लर्न फ्रॉम अ टीचर, दे कैन लर्न फ्रॉम एनीबडी ऑन द नेट. देयर सो मेनी टॉक्स, देयर आर सो मेनी दिस, सो द वर्ल्ड इज ओपन. हमारे ज़माने में तो मोबाइल फ़ोन भी नहीं था. हमारे ज़माने में अगर हमारी गर्लफ्रेंड का फ़ोन आता था स्टूडियो में, तो उनको बोलना पड़ता था कि 1:15 पे फ़ोन करो और तब मैं फ़ोन के पास आऊँगा. तो एक ही फ़ोन होती थी स्टूडियो में और लाइन लगी रहती थी फ़ोन करने वालों की और फ़ोन रिसीव करने वालों की. एंड कैन यू इमेजिन टुडे मोबाइल फ़ोन, आई मीन दिस कम्युनिकेशन, आई मीन यू हैड टू, those were very hard times, nowadays very hard times, garmi, no air conditioned studios, the infrastructure that we had, the way we used to travel, God. Hotels is tarah ki thi. Aajkal to aap to jannat mein aajkal, I think all the actors. Memories of my school days. See, my memory, to sum it up, I was always very confident of achieving anything that I put, whenever I put my mind to something, I knew that I could do it. I wanted to be totally fearless, no fear of anything. You know, whether it was your parents, teachers, whether it was your colleagues. And that got me into a lot of trouble also. But at the same time, it made me so, you know, confident and absolutely self-independent of anybody. So, us tarah se, I think, but you know, everybody goes through life in his own way. I've been very special, I've been very grateful that I've lived such a life that I think very few people can even dream of living. आपकी आवाज एको हो रही है मेरे को सुनाई नहीं
आर डी बर्मन के ऊपर बायोपिक बननी चाहिए
आर डी बर्मन ऑफ कोर्स माय गॉड ही वाज सच अ जीनियस बन रही है ना कोई बना रहा है ऑफ कोर्स अच्छा
आपके नजर से मोस्ट सूटेबल एक्टर कौन सा होगा अगर आप बताएं
क्या फैक्टर
सूटेबल एक्टर टू एक्ट एज
सॉरी आई एम नॉट अ कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर आई एम नॉट अ कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर No, I agree. I mean, there will always be, you know, some
thief to hamesha hi zinda the. Hamesha rahe.
You see, everything.
Chor jo tha pehle bhi hota tha, 200 saal pehle, 100 saal pehle, 50 saal pehle. वो अपना तरीका निकाल लेगा अगर आप बोलेंगे चोरों को रोक सकते हैं तो नहीं रोक सकते पर ये परसेंट 2% 1% 5% नहीं रहता है 90% उस परसेंट चोर नहीं 90% लोग फिल्म देखने वाले तरीके से ही
आपके हिसाब से
इसके बारे में तो हम टिप्पणी कर नहीं सकते क्योंकि हमें केस नहीं मालूम लेकिन ये है कि लीकेज होना पायरेसी होना ये हमेशा शुरू से ही हमारी प्रॉब्लम रही
है बट वी मस्ट एक्सेप्ट दिस फैक्ट before the Vajpayee ji government came into being, film industry was not recognized as an industry. हमारे यहाँ film industry को कोई दांत नहीं देता था कोई उनका ज़्यादा respect नहीं होता था जब भी कोई problem government पर आता था उन दिनों में तो income tax raids हो जाते थे actors पर और headlines सब हो जाते थे कि इसको raid कर दिया उसको raid कर दिया उसको जो भी खामियाँ government में होती थी फर्स्ट टाइम वाजपेयी जी अडवाणी जी रिकग्नाइज द फिल्म इंडस्ट्री हमको इंडस्ट्री का स्टेटस मिला हम लोगों को फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशन से बैंक से पैसे मिलने शुरू हुए टू फाइनेंस फिल्म्स सो दैट वाज अ वेरी बिग स्टेप दैट दे टुक
मुक्तान वाज द फर्स्ट कॉर्पोरेट कंपनी बिकॉज़ इंडस्ट्री रिकग्नाइज की गई थी
सो दैट वाज द स्टार्ट ऑफ दिस होल रेवोल्यूशन आई थिंक दैट चेंज दिस होल इन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री फाइनेंस मनी पहले सारा मनी अंडरवर्ल्ड इधर उधर कहाँ कहाँ से आता था पता है नाउ एवरीथिंग इज लीगल वी आर एक्सेप्टेड एज एनी अदर इंडस्ट्री
इंश्योरेंस फॉर फिल्म्स आई थिंक थिंग्स हैव चेंज्ड अ लॉट इफ यू टॉक अबाउट देन एंड नाउ यस दे हैड अदर चैलेंजेस लाइक ही सेड देयर वाज नो एयर कंडीशनिंग इन द स्टूडियोज टुडे वी मे हैव एयर कंडीशनिंग बट देन देयर इज टेक्नोलॉजी फॉर पायरेसी टू हैपन मोर इजीली सो आई थिंक वी मस्ट एक्सेप्ट दैट लाइफ इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू बी अ बैलेंस बिटवीन good times and bad times and we have to face these challenges this generation has to face these challenges so I think that's summing it up
subhash ji khannai ka sequel dekhne milega hame khannai return ka bhi charcha
hai main shorat bilkul mishri woods ke 10th year ke convocation pe baitha ek mulaqat fir karenge jab hum khannai ki baat
karenge kafi charcha
aur khul ke baat karenge main bhi bata baat thank you
thank you
thank you
They just want to take a...
All the best and thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.